Going to explain about 8.1 first question. So what is this first question means? And first I'm going to explain about NCRTs, then I'm going to explain about after that I'm going to explain about TS and AP. The first 8.1 first question of this is in triangle ABC. Now I'm going to explain. This is the first question in triangle 8.1 exercise from the NCERT. In triangle ABC, right angle to B, AB equals 24 centimeters, so BC equals to 7 centimeters. Determine sin A cos A, sin C cos C. So पहला इसको क्या करना? First let us consider right angle को consider करो. Let us take this as consider right angle triangle AB. See, AB equals to 24 centimeters, BC equals centimeters. This is hypotenuse. Next, according to Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equals to opposite square plus adjacent square. So what is hypotenuse square? Is equals to 24 square plus 7 square. They are asking here. So hypotenuse square is equals to 24 means 576 plus 49. 24 into 24, 576. So hypotenuse square is equals to 625. Hypo is equals to root over 625. Then hypotenuse is equals to 25 centimeters. So what is the value of hypotenuse? 25 centimeters. Hypotenuse equals 25 centimeters. So now what we have to find here is sine A. Okay, sine A. A B C. We want sine A. Sine A means opposite by hypotenuse. If they given theta here, ओके इधर टीटा चॉइस करें तो क्या है ये एंगल ए सो यू टेक एन टीटा हियर देन दिस विल बी 25 इट बिकम्स एडजेसेंट साइड एंड दिस साइड बिकम्स अपोजिट साइड दिस हाइपोटेनस नेवर चेंजेस बट अपोजिट एंड हाइपोटेनस चेंजेस अकॉर्डिंग टू द एंगल द टीटा टीटा इज हियर एंगल ए इज हियर देन this is adjacent side and this is opposite side. This is adjacent side, this is opposite side. Adjacent here, this is opposite. Okay, so sine A. Do you want, we want sine A. Sine A equals to what is opposite here? 7. 7 by 24. Then cos A. Cos A equals to adjacent by hypotenuse. That is cos A is equals to what is adjacent angle? 7. 7 by 25. So here also 25, not 24. 25. 20 adjacent na? Sorry, so 24 by 25. Adjacent means 24 by 25. So adjacent means 24 by 25. Opposite means 7 by 25. Next, if you take here, sine, they want, next you want sin C cos C. So A B C, then theta is here. If you want theta here, then this becomes adjacent side, this becomes opposite, so it becomes hypotenuse. 25 centimeter hypotenuse same as it is, whereas comes to this, this will be 7 same as it is. The numbers never changes but sides will be changes. okay, numericals never changes, but size will be changes. Okay, I am taking theta here, so sine c is equals to opposite by adjacent, same opposite by hypotenuse, same as it is. Okay, now this will be value changes. So what is here? Opposite means 24, hypotenuse means 25. So sine c is equals to 24/25. Next to cos c, cos c is equals to means adjacent by hypotenuse, adjacent by hypotenuse. Okay, now what is adjacent value? Adjacent is this 7/25. Okay, are you getting? Next they want, what they want is, what they want is, sine c. So we choose. So this is the first question in 8.1. In triangle AB is right angle at B, AB equals 20 centimeters and BC equals 10 centimeters. Determine sine A cos C. Okay, sine A comma cos A, sine C comma cos A. So according to Pythagoras theorem, we read. So this is 24, this is 7, Pythagoras. According to the hypotenuse, according to Pythagoras theorem, opposite square by adjacent square, this total we got it. So here, if theta is here, so the sides will be changes. Where the theta will be, there it will be adjacent and opposite. And theta is here, sine C. If you want, sine C. C, either C. Okay, now for the C, the theta will be here. So where the theta will be there, this adjacent side, this is opposite side. I hope you got this. Okay, next we are going to. So now, second one, find tan P minus cot A according to this figure. So first, tan theta is equals to opposite by adjacent, then tan P. If you choose here tan P, then this becomes adjacent side, theta is here, then becomes opposite side. Okay, tan P is equals to, what is that, PQ by QR. We don't know QR value, so by using Pythagoras theorem, Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equals to opposite square plus adjacent square. So this is hypotenuse, it will be hypotenuse square means 13 square is equals to 12 square plus opposite square. So 169 minus 144, 12 square 144 is equals to opposite square. This 25 is equals to opposite square. Then opposite equals to root 25, square becomes 25, then 5 centimeters. Okay, 5 centimeters. Then we have to find tan P first. Tan P is equals to PQ by QR. So that PQ, what is PQ here? So PQ is equals to 12 centimeters, QR is equals to 25 centimeters, PR is equals to 13 centimeters. So PQ, that will be 12 by 5. So tan P is equals to 12/5. Next step, they want cot R. For this, again the theta will be shifted. Here P, Q, R. The theta is here, then this becomes adjacent side, this becomes opposite side, this value is now same as it is 25 centimeters, and this will be 12 centimeters, but the sides will be different. Then cot r equals to adjacent by opposite, then cot r is equals to what is the adjacent value? Adjacent is 5 by 12. Okay, 5 by 12. Then what we have to do is tan p minus cot r. So what is tan p value? Tan p minus cot r. Tan p is 12 by 5 minus cot r is 5 by 12. Then LCM of 5 and 12 is 60. Then multiply into 12 into 12 into 5 into 5. 12 is 144 minus 25 by 60. Then 144 minus 25, carrying here 14, 9, 3, 1. Sorry, 3, 2, 1, 119. 119 by 60. 144, 25, 9. Sorry, 119. 119 plus 25, 4, 14. Yeah, 119 by 16. This is the value what we got. Okay, now? What is the value what we got for this? Okay. Total value. Find tan p minus tan r. This is the total value what we got. Okay, now? Second one. Now we are going for third one. Now sin a equals to 3 by 4. Calculate cos a. Tan A. Already we know that sin A equals to 3 by 4 means opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite by hypotenuse. Now consider right angle triangle. Right angle triangle A, B, C. So A, B, C. Opposite by opposite adjacent. Okay. Now go with Pythagoras theorem. Then hypotenuse square is equals to opposite square plus adjacent square. So the given hypotenuse is 4. Hypotenuse is 4. So now it will be four square is equals to opposite square is 3 square plus adjacent square. Adjacent square. Then if you want adjacent square is equals to 16 minus 9. Adjacent equals to root 7 centimeters. Root 7 centimeters. Root 7 centimeters. Adjacent equals root 7 centimeters. Adjacent equals to root 7 centimeters. Then next what we have to find is cos A. Cos A value. Cos A equals to what do you want? Cos A equals to adjacent by hypotenuse. So cos A equals to what? Adjacent value root 7. Root 7 by 4. Then they want tan A value. Tan A equals to opposite by adjacent. So they want tan A value. Tan A equals to opposite is 3 by root 7. Okay, so this is the tan A value, this is the cos A value, tan A value, and this is the cos A value. Okay, next we are going for next question. Now this will be the question. Sin 15 cot A equals to 8, find sin A cos A. For this what we have to do is cot A is equals to 8 by 15. So please bring this 8 to here. Here multiplication becomes division. Now it will be adjacent by opposite. Now let us try to draw right angle triangle for this A B C. This is a theta, then adjacent means this theta means adjacent side, it will be h, this will be 15. You want hypotenuse, same by Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square plus is equals to opposite square plus adjacent square. So hypotenuse you want, hypotenuse square is equals to 8 square plus 15 square, 64 plus 225. Hypotenuse square is equals to 289. Hypo equals to root 289, then hypo equals to 17. Hypo equals to 17. So hypo you got it, 17 value. Now what we have to do is next thing is find sin A. Sin A is equals to opposite by hypotenuse. Then sin A is equals to what is opposite? Opposite value is 15. Hypotenuse is 17. This is sin A value. Next they want secant A. Secant A is reciprocal of 1 by cos. So 1 by cos is equals to what is that? 1 by adjacent by hypotenuse. So it becomes reverse, hypotenuse by adjacent. So then secant A is equals to reverse of cos, hypotenuse by adjacent. Then what is the value? This secant A equals to 17 by h. Okay, this is a secant A value. Okay, now this is the fourth question, is given in NCERT. So secant A equals 13 by 12, calculate all the trigonometric ratios. First let us write secant theta is equals to 13 by 12, it will be what is that? Hypo by adjacent. So let us consider right angle triangle. All this based on right angle triangle A B C. Now theta if you take here, this will be adjacent and this will be opposite, this will be hypo. The given hypo equals to 13, adjacent equals to 12, opposite we don't know. Same by Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equals to opposite square plus adjacent square. Hypotenuse square is 13 square, opposite square we don't know, opposite square, adjacent square is 12 square. So if you want opposite square, it will be 13 square is 169 minus 144, then opposite square is equals to 25, opposite is equals to root 25, opposite equals to 5 centimeters. This is the opposite value, you got this. Next they are asking all trigonometric terms. Okay, first sin theta is equals to opposite by adjacent. Then what is the value of sine theta? It will be sine theta equals to opposite is 5 by 12, that's it. Then cos theta is equals to, so hypotenuse, opposite by hypotenuse, sorry, 13. Then cos theta is equals to adjacent by hypotenuse, so it will be reverse, 12 by 13. Tan theta is equals to opposite by adjacent, so what is opposite, 5 by 12. Cot theta is reverse of tan, so adjacent by opposite, that is 12 by 5. Then cosecant theta, reverse of sine, that is hypotenuse by opposite. Hypotenuse how much? 13 by opposite is 5. Okay, all these are the trigonometric terms. Okay, calculate trigonometric ratio. Next we are going for 6th question. We are going for, so now this will be 7th question. Cot theta equals 7 by 8. Evaluate 1 plus sine theta, 1 minus sine theta by 1 plus cos theta, 1 minus cos theta. First let us write. Same as it is. Cot theta is equals to, cot theta is equals to, cot theta is equals to 7 by 8. It will be adjacent by opposite. Same according to right angle triangle. Hypotenuse square is equals to opposite square plus adjacent square, then 7 square plus 8 square. Hypotenuse is equals to 7 square is 49 plus this one is 64. Total hypo is equals to root 113. This is the hypotenuse. Next we want what we want is, first question, 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus sin theta is equals to a plus b into a minus b, that will be a square minus b square, a square minus b square, so 1 square minus sin square theta, 1 square minus sin square theta, so 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus sin theta can be written as 1 minus sin square theta, so nothing but 1 minus sin square is cos square theta equals to cos square theta, cos square theta, 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta is equals to 1 minus cos square theta, 1 minus cos square is equals to sin square theta, sin square theta. So now according to the first question, cos square theta by sin square theta, why? Because in the place of 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus sin theta is sin cos square theta, 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos square theta is sin square theta, nothing but cos by sin is cot square theta. Cos theta, cot theta can be written as, can be written as, can be written as cot theta is equals to cos theta by sin theta, therefore cot square theta is equals to cos theta by sin theta, sin theta, sin theta whole square. So now cot square, what is cot, what is cot, cot will be 7 by 8, here you can write 7 by 8 whole square is equals to 7 square by 8 square, that is 49 by 64. Okay, for first question, 49 by 64 answer will be. For second question, same question, they are asking what is cot square theta. So we know that cot theta is equals to 7 by 8. Same as it is, cot square theta is equals to 7 by 8 whole square. So that will be square splitting for both 7 square by 8 square, that is 49 by 64. So cot square theta is equals to 49 by 64. How each and everyone got this? Okay, next question, we are going for 9th question.